Welcome back to White Wall Wednesday. My name is Brooke, and today we are taking advantage of our actual white wall. Well, in my case, it's a blue wall, so maybe we should change this to Blue Wall Wednesday, but you get the point. The point is that I am creating something with my blank wall today, and we're actually utilizing this space. So there's no compositing involved today. We are going to use the blank space that we have and create something simple but impactful here. So what is the idea? The theme of today's image will be eraser. So essentially I'm going to create with white paint, put it all over my face and body, and then cover up my eyes with two pieces of blank paper. The idea here is that I am erasing my body, but we're making use of texture. Texture makes photography so beautiful. It takes a blank space and makes it interesting. It makes the viewer feel like they can reach out and touch the picture, and that's an amazing thing to be able to do. Photography is naturally so flat. It's two-dimensional. You can't literally reach out and touch it like you could a sculpture or something like that. Even paintings, while two-dimensional, have paint on them, and so many painters utilize that technique of putting lots of paint on the canvas so that it looks really tactile. The goal today is to create an image that people feel like they can reach out and touch by creating multiple types of textures, from the paper that we're going to use to the paint on my skin and texture that we might add in Photoshop too. I'm even choosing my costume based on texture. So I'm using an ace bandage today. This is just something that you would wrap your body in if you got injured. Just really simple, stretchy. I use ace bandages constantly in my work because it's really neutral, doesn't even have a color, has great texture to it, and it just looks like skin. So you can wrap this around somebody and create that effect. If this doesn't match your skin color, you can always add paint to it to lighten it or darken it depending on what you need. So this is a really great option, and it's a throwaway thing too. This isn't something that I need to reuse. They cost just a few dollars at the store, so I'm using an ace bandage today. Things took a turn for the weird in the just, I swear to you, 2 minutes that I had the camera off. I was getting dressed into my ace bandage and I found fabric on the floor and I thought, well, that would be a great addition for modesty purposes. I can put it on underneath. So that's a really good option. If you have just random fabrics lying around, layer them into your costumes and see how it looks, because I really liked it. And then I found another ace bandage, which I also added, and then I found rope, as you can clearly see. So I added this rope in and it's just more texture. So essentially what I'm doing is saying, how much texture can I possibly fit into this photo in the simplest way that I can? So I've added rope, I've added ace bandage, I have cloth, I'll have paint, I have hair, skin tone, and more. I mean, whatever we add in Photoshop. So this is the most fun way to build a costume. These are the two pieces of paper that I'm going to put over my eyes, and that's going to be featured in the image. I just ripped them out of this really cool paper that I have. I have this body paint that I'm going to be using today as well. I got this online. I have not used this before, so I'm not sure if this is actually the best thing to use. I usually just use like kids' finger paints and stuff like that. We'll see if this ever comes off, but I'm sure it will. It's going to be fine. It says body paint. I'm putting it on my body. So that's what I'll do now. I'm just trying to create streaks and have some areas that look a little bit heavier with it and some that look less. And the goal here is to make this look like an actual painting. Like when I hold my arm up, I don't know the pose I'm going to do exactly, so I'm kind of covering my bases. I want it to look like there are paint strokes. I'm gonna cover up my tattoo. Also good for that, apparently. And you want to think like you're the camera, right? So like I'm looking at myself and I can see my body somewhat, but I can't see all of it. You can see more than me. So I know, for example, that like I always miss my neck. That's just an area that I always miss. I got to get that. And I don't know how it looks. I mean, it might look just awful right now. Who knows? But, got to start somewhere, right? Now I'm just getting my hair strands, maybe. Making it up as I go. I had better see what this looks like. The last thing that I want to mention, great timing, right? Like, I should have said this before. The last thing that I want to mention when you're shooting with your blank wall is to consider how close or far away you are from the wall. So for me, I'm going to get a little bit further away from the wall to make the wall a little bit blurry, because even though there is a natural texture on the wall, I want to add my own. I just don't need any like crazy shadows on the wall or anything like that, so I'm going to move away to create some separation, which is a great way to make it look like you're not standing in front of a wall. Thank you for watching this White Wall Wednesday with me. I hope that it inspires you to get out there and just be creative, get messy, do something fun, play with texture, and use your blank wall, whatever that looks like for you, whether it's super cluttered or really clean, it doesn't matter. Have fun, have playtime, remember to get a little bit messy sometimes, and happy White Wall Wednesday. Remember to subscribe if you like these videos, pass it along to your friends, leave me a comment, and that helps me create more videos. Thanks, guys!